Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to the Electrical Power Transmission course. Today I am going to explain about the calculation of sag at equal and unequal levels. Sag and tension of a conductor can be calculated for the two cases. Number 1, when the supports are at equal levels. Number 2, when the supports are at unequal levels. Now I am going to derive an expression for the sag calculation when supports are at equal level. Consider a conductor between two equal level supports A and B with O as the lowest point as shown in the figure. It can be proved that lowest point will be at the mid span. Let L is the length of the span, W is the weight per unit length of the conductor, T is the tension in the conductor. Consider a point P on the conductor. Taking the lowest point O as the origin, let the coordinates of the point P be X and Y. Assuming that the curvature is so small that curved length is equal to its horizontal projection given by OP is equal to X. The two forces acting on the portion OP of the conductors are A. The weight Wx of the conductor acting at a distance x upon 2 from the O. B. The tension T acting at O. Equating the movements of above two forces about point O, we get the following expression. From this expression, the formula for Y will become as below. The maximum dip or sag is represented by the value of Y at either of the supports A and B. At support A, x is equal to L upon 2 and y is equal to S. Therefore, sag becomes as below. S is equal to W L square upon 8T. The equation shows that the sag in a freely suspended conductor is directly proportional to the weight per unit length of the conductor, square of the span length, and inversely proportional to the horizontal tension. Now I am going to derive an expression for sag calculation when supports are at unequal level. In hilly areas, transmission lines generally come across conductors suspended between supports at unequal levels. Figure shows a conductor suspended between two supports A and B which are at different levels. The lowest point on the conductor is O. Let L is the span length, H is the difference in level between the two supports. X1 is the distance of support at lower level A from O. X2 is the distance of support at higher level B from O. T is the tension in the conductor. If W is the weight per unit length of the conductor, then there exist two sag given as below. Sag S1 is equal to WX1 square upon 2T. Sag S2 is equal to WX2 square upon 2T. Just look at the figure. It can be noticed that X1 plus X2 is equal to L. If we subtract both sag, we may get the equation as below. X2 square minus X1 squares equal to X2 minus X1 into X2 plus X1. We already know that X2 plus X1 is equal to the length. Therefore, the final equation becomes as below. But we also know that S2 minus S1 is equal to H. Therefore, the equation will become as below. Putting the value of x1 in equation B and solving it, we get the expression for x2 as below. Similarly, by putting the value of x2 in equation B and solving it, we get the expression for x1 as below. Therefore, by using x1 and x2, the values of s1 and s2 can be easily calculated. Now I am going to discuss the effect of ice and wind on the sag. It may be noted that the above expressions for sag are true only in normal air and at normal temperature when the conductor is acted by its weight only. The weight of the conductors acts vertically downward and depends upon the type of the conductor used. However, in actual practice, a conductor may have ice coating and simultaneously subjected to wind pressure. The weight of ice acts vertically downward in the same direction as the weight of the conductor. The force due to wind pressure is assumed to be act horizontally at the right angle to the projected surface of the conductor as shown in the figure. Hence, the total force on the conductor is the vector sum of horizontal and vertical forces as shown in the figure. Total weight of the conductor per unit length is given as below. where W is equal to weight of the conductor per unit length, which is given by conductor material density into volume per unit length. Wi is the weight of ice per unit length, which is equal to density of the ice into volume of the ice per unit length. As we know that the volume of circular object is equal to pi r square h. Just look at the figure that d is the diameter of the conductor and t is the thickness due to ice. This thickness exists on both sides of the conductor. Therefore, total diameter will become d plus 2t. If we subtract the actual diameter of the conductor from this total diameter, we will get the diameter of ice thickness. Therefore, the above equation becomes as below. Density of the ice into pi upon 4 into d plus 2t whole square minus d square into 1, where h is considered 1 meter and radius is equal to diameter upon 2. Solving this expression, we get the following expression. Now, Ww is equal to wind force per unit length, which is equal to wind pressure per unit area into projected area per unit length. Again, we know that area is equal to length into width. From the figure 1, width is equal to d plus 2t and length is 1 meter. Putting these values, we get the following expression. It may be noted that when the conductor has wind and ice loading, the conductor sets itself in a plane at an angle theta to the vertical given as below. Friends, in this lecture, I have derived the expression for the calculation of sag at equal and unequal levels. Furthermore, I have derived the expression to include the effect of ice and wind effect on the sag calculation. That's all for today's lecture. I hope you really enjoyed this lecture. Friends, I upload many videos based on various topics of power system and motivation on regular basis. Therefore, don't forget to subscribe my channel in order not to miss my latest videos. And don't forget to share my videos with your friends and class fellows so that they can also get benefit from these videos. Thank you very much.